Hello there, friend, and welcome to our final day. Can you believe it? Our final day of 37 days of prayer and devotion, and so grateful for what God has already cultivated and planted in us, and so excited about what He has out here in front of us in 2020. For our final day together, as you look there in your journal, we're looking at Hebrews chapter 11, specifically over men and women who spent their life fulfilling the vision of God on their life. And yet it says that they didn't quite get it all done before they died and went to their home. And it says this, that they were working with home in mind. In other words, they were working out their vision with heaven in mind. And so I want to just conclude as we go into 2020 to reckon with the fact that all that we're doing, all the things that we're trying to accomplish and all the people we're trying to reach, ultimately, it is because this life is not all there is. Heaven really is our home. And inside you and inside me and inside every person that we're trying to reach, there is a longing that can't be fulfilled on this earth. There is a holy homesickness that God placed there. And He did it to draw each person toward heaven and toward home. And with that, very recently, or over the last 4 years, my father passed away 4 years ago, and something new awakened in me that I wasn't quite prepared for. I started driving back to my hometown, going to my baseball fields where I was a kid that I played ball, football fields, my old schools, driving roads. For some reason, I was in my hometown trying to feel something, and it was good. There was good nostalgia there. But God helped me to understand what I was looking for, that longing for feeling home, that I actually couldn't get it satisfied by driving around those places, that God had put it there. And ultimately, I won't get it satisfied on this planet. I'll get it satisfied when I get to the real home, the home He's built for me. I say this to you to encourage you, because what it started to do, knowing that that longing was there, it started fueling new vision for the way I worshiped, fueling vision for the way I acted and the way I treated people, and the reasons for which I reached out to people that are unsaved, because the truth is they have a holy homesickness inside of them that they're trying to fulfill. As we go into 2020, one, I want to just acknowledge that inside of you, there is a longing that you're going to try to fulfill through vacations and buying certain things and have at it. Do the best you can. God put it there to help you turn your head toward your true home, which is heaven. And He also did it so that you would understand the people around you have the same holy homesickness. And as we go about fulfilling the vision and call of God on our life this year, we can know this. God wants to plunder hell and fill heaven with all of these people that we're trying to reach. And so with that, let's go into 2021, excited that this isn't all there is. There's something far grander. I hadn't seen, ear hasn't heard, nor has it entered into the imagination of man what God has prepared for us. But there is a bit of a longing in us that draws us that way. So let's let that fuel our worship and our prayer and our devotion, but as well, knowing that every life that we look at, ultimately it's going to end. And God wants all of those people as well to join us in our heavenly home. So with that, let's get fueled for 2020 to reach as many people as we can for the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? Let me pray with you. Heavenly Father, this has been a wonderful time of prayer and devotion and listening to You and allowing You to fuel fresh vision in our church, in us as individuals, in my friend, my brother or my sister who's praying with me right now. And ultimately, God, it is so that we can plunder hell and fill heaven with thousands and thousands and thousands of souls. So God, I ask You, Lord, would You anoint the vision that You've placed in our hearts and lives? Would You cause us to be fueled with just a fresh energy to reach as many people as we can? And we pray with an audacious faith, Lord, again, would You save tens of thousands of people through our lives over 2020? Would You do a grand and a great work as we turn our heart toward You? Thank You for this vision. Thank You for 37 days. And thank You now, God. We go in faith to achieve, to accomplish what you've called us to do in the year 2020. Thank you, God, in Jesus' name for going before us. We go in faith now, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's going to be a great, great year.